So what if this place is attacked again? We don't have all this stuff to protect it. No, not times. Whatever this is. Garavia Sound. You touch the name, blah blah blah. Why are we slowing down like this? Oh my. The view screen shows the vast sea to the south. Two peninsulas embrace the waters for many kilometers, then the sea stretches out to the horizon. Why this? Why are we having frame rate hits with text? The sea is placid. A small number of ships ply the harbor, seeking fish or sunken artifacts. You know what? I'm on 60 right now. No, my frames aren't changing. Still 60. Recent past. Oh my god, we're getting slower and slower. Oh, I'm trying to hit 4. Maybe I'll go faster now anyway. Locations. Yeah, it's better. I'm already set on it, aren't I? Alright, let's choose, you know what, let's just look. You're already set to that, yeah. Strange ships come and go, both sea and air, bringing trade goods from places you cannot see beyond the horizon. Distant past. A long time ago, the cliff sides had defensive batteries built into the rock. All of these have collapsed or fallen into ruin. An enormous martling whale glides into the bay with a small village built on its back. Before it can reach the cliffs, the batteries thunder into life, destroying the whale and the entire village. Oh, damn. Do we mean to do that? Or just wander into, you know, attack radius. Huh. So I think we're done. These are all the locations. I looked at all the times. Random. So what about this? Use spatial network. Examine an interface. Points on the map are connected by bright glowing lines. State your destination. Wait, are these the same? Reef of Fallen Worlds, Colm Village. Yeah. If we press the eyes, inspect. The map changes color. Each of the bright points in turn lights up, as well as every connection between them. After a minute of this, the map fades. A voice speaks the truth directly into your mind. No problems found. If you are experiencing trouble with the temporal network, please consult your system conservator. Alright, before I go anywhere, I'm assuming this is just going to bring us some new place if we go there. You know what? I can use this. Use spatial network to go to where I want to go. Cliff's Edge. Without using more speed points. Because now I'm going to try to see if we can climb down. What's down there? It's not here. Is it in Caravanserai then?
At last.
All right. Are we going or what? No. Thank you. I'm gonna go back to the whatever of many names, or last names, actually. Yeah, here it is. Cave of the Last Words.
In this world, then.
We didn't find out.
I am the very soul of action.
The Phalethis isn't a machine, is it? No. Yeah, let's go this way.
Bye.
Okay, this way.
Yes, now.
We can just go here. Very interesting atmosphere in there with the sounds and music. Okay, now. From this height you can see everything. Beyond the city of Sega's cliffs, bluffs and chasms extend toward the horizon on either side for at least 50 kilometers. The sea stretches between them, perhaps 20 kilometers across at its widest. Then the waters widen and swallow the horizon. Jump. Let's look down. The tiers of Sega's cliffs spread out to your right, a jumble of streets and buildings. To the left is the opening of a dark chasm. Tendrils of flesh cling to the edges like vines. The ocean lies almost 1,000 meters below you, dark and dangerous. Scavenging and fishing sloops crawl slowly across its surface. The rooftops of a few Sega's homes jut from the cliff's surface, but mostly it's a clear drop to the sea. Perception check. You realize you're standing in a shallow depression worn away by more than just weather. The ground and the lip of the ledge are worn smooth from human traffic. Thousands must have come here over the centuries, looking at the sea and contemplating their own demise. Okay, what about over here? All the same. It's just two. Oh, there's a third. Just want to see if there's anything different. Okay, I know we're past 48, just... Jump! Red Tide. You leap into the air. Moderate amount, huh? The fall is exhilarating. Wind rushes past you, faster and faster, stretching your face like it was made of putty. The boats in the sea grow at an alarming rate. The calls of fishermen and scavengers reach your ears, distorted by the speed. Finally, you slam into the water, the impact as hard as if it were an ocean of bedrock. Then there is only darkness. We can't die. I can just return. Sated my curiosity anyway. So I guess this is a quick place to return to the, you know, the Fathom if we need to. Or the Calm, rather. Nothing new.
I'm going.
And back we go. Back out of my mind. Where am I now? Death. Imbitu. The stink of it. Dried blood and rotting flesh fills your nostrils. This is your first clue that you are somehow still alive. The second is the glow of candlelight, warm on your eyelids, and the icy stone beneath your back. Slippers scuff the ground near your head. Ah, says an elderly man, our mysterious visitor is alive after all. I am glad we waited to feast. Though you were quite dead when we found you. Open your eyes, child. Of course, this is no surprise. It says Imbitu right here. So I know where I am. You think she would have been quite an interesting specimen, but not dead. No, not dead. Open our eyes. Despite the glare of the dim candles, which seem, at least momentarily, as bright as sunlight, you see a cluster of robed figures. Only Imbitu remains where he was, clasping his hands together with unfiltered delight, his teeth brown and jagged. Ugh. Brush your teeth, man. I knew that you were special. He whispers. So many eyes have settled on that face, moving through the crowds, chin high and proud, sunlight kissing that wonderful tattoo. He reaches out a trembling finger towards it. Don't touch me. Silver tie, tiny amount. Of course, he says, lifting his finger. Then he glances at you sidelong, almost shyly. I'm afraid I must ask you for a simply unthinkable favor. And I'm probably saying no. You may have suspected that we were going to eat you, he says, raising a bony finger. This is somewhat true, but only so that the wonders of your life would not be lost. He looks down bashfully. And now that we know you cannot die, well, would you do us the honor of letting us eat you? Just a little bit? No. If you do, we will share some of our deepest mysteries, and yours, with you. He folds his hands, and we'll pay you, of course. No. I mean, maybe I'll come back another time, if I really need knowledge. I'd rather not be eaten. Of course, he says, raising his hand. His followers step away, looking disappointed. Do let me know if you change your mind. Huh, he thinks, unless some errant knife changes it for you. Huh. Do take your time getting to your feet. I would imagine that you're quite dizzy. I'm already up before you finish saying it. Anything new? Just checking to make sure. What do you want, shoal meat? Here.
Of course.
That was interesting.
Fine.
to Government Square, Circus Minor, Cliff's Edge.
Yes, now.
You guys leaving or what?
Egg friend!
Chiquette whistles. The smell of dust and closed air surrounds it. The creature is clearly glad to see you.
Stike a deep dig, like promise. Rock not as good there.
The scent of a pocket of trapped gas arises, the equivalent of a shrug.
But you can't promise. Stike a move. Human want travel?
Huh. If you've moved your people deeper underground, can you take me to your old lair?
It's empty now. No Stika. No eggs.
The creature regards you carefully, as if trying to discern your purpose. Then you catch a scent like fresh air sweeping through a tunnel, the equivalent, perhaps, of a dismissive shrug.
We'll take egg friend. No need to pay.
Crap. So we can go in the airship. We can go to all these different places, I assume. Emerging from the freshly dug tunnel, you find yourself in a small chamber with veins of refined metal glimmering along the ground and walls. Chiquette turns to face you.
Place beyond was egg rooms, hatching chambers.
Its claws work up and down slowly.
Future Stika move far away. Sanctuary on other side of Not Nest.
Was there anything here to be found?
Let's go.
There's gotta be some reason for us to be here. Without the fragment that repelled the others, the vine has wound itself back together.
All right.
The soft, hypnotic vibrations continue to resonate from the statue. It's too subtle to be felt from more than a few meters away, before the statue is damaged, the sounds are probably audible over a wider area. Well, if there's anything... And that just closes that passage.
Yes, now.
The glowing statue emits a low hum that tugs lightly at your mind, trying to draw your attention. The Stika cannot seem to resist it as you can.
No.
Same. Are you stuck? No, you're right here. Oh, there's something there. Ooh, loot.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Cool. 31 shins and a brood's ears. When you insert this set of plugs into your ears, you can suddenly hear through the ears of another being. Pulling out the earplugs and reinserting them into your ears links you to a different individual. Overheard speech seems to be completely incomprehensible and alien each time, so the target individuals are probably distant in space or time or both. Huh. And that exits out. We still have weird, like, Stika noises, even though they're not here. I assume that was the sound of their babies and stuff. The eggs. Where is this thing? Oh, brood's ears. We can't do anything with them. Apparently. Well, that's cool. I love finding these little things, so that alone is worth something to me. I came from here.
Of course.
If I activate all these, is it going to take me over? I can't walk that way.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I couldn't,
On it.
I know it's a waste.
All right.
We're not that damaged, though. Huh. Okay. We're done in here. I guess we came back for these broodier things. I don't know if they were here before and I missed them, or they are new. So now we find ourselves back at the crossroads of stuff. There's the mural. So, either this is another mural, or this is part of the building which disappeared. Or was demolished.
Yes.
And what is this thing for? Data flickers and flashes around this machine too quickly for you to make any sense of it. You learn nothing new about the machine. Oh. A little dramatic music for nothing. Travel to Circus Minor through the side mirrors. Interesting. Hail. Alright. He's over here, this guy. I want to talk to him again. The genocide. And we can use this to go back as well.
All right.
Hopefully I can tell whether he's telling me anything new or not. He watches you, hardly moving, as if he hopes you will pass by quickly. Shield generators. They unmoored the city. Most have broken. Only powers. One powers the nearby clock. Oh. Alright, now that's it. No. I wish you no good tidings. Oh, thank you. You're such a sweetie. Caravanserai. How about travel to the peak of the city? Where's that? The invisible line yanks you up into the roaring darkness. I mean, what is the peak? Cliff's edge? Oh, here's Zebb! We're in Government Square. Just didn't tell us it was Government Square. Was he here before? How does this door thing work? Doesn't she know? Allison smiles at you. Hello, you're right on time. She strokes Zeb's hair, soothing him. He's wrapped his arms tightly around himself and is staring at something you can't see. Were they standing here before when I came around here with Rin? What do you say, Zeb? Looking forward to having a new family? He's lost in his own thoughts and doesn't respond. Well then. Elsin steps into Zeb's line of vision, gently lifting his chin with a finger so he's looking at her. Is there anything you'd like to say? She shakes his head. He shakes his head, sorry, balling his hands into fists. He looks like he's about to cry. And you? Alson's gaze is compassionate, yet hopeful. She thinks, love is confidence. Send the boy off with some. Just imagine Nim's one step behind you. Gold weighs a tiny amount. Zebb stares at you, overcome by terror. Alson places a hand on his shoulder and he startles. His whole body tenses as if he's about to run away, and then all of the energy drains out of him. He turns to face the gate. Its striating light throws his features into sharp relief. Thanks. He starts walking forward before you or Alson can reply, his movements stiff and unnatural. Did she do something to him? Did she drain the energy out of him with his shoulder? With her hand on his shoulder? And he walks right through me. Awesome. Wow. Well, Alson smiles at you, exhausted. I'm sure Zeb's new family are delighted to have him. No new questions. Take care. Okay. Oh, is this the generator?
All right.
Now they know what these things are. Caravanserai. Yeah, at the cliffs. Okay. Quite an exit we make, huh? We've been playing for a long time. Awesome. Okay. Let's level up Eritus, and next time we're going to try going places. I mean, it's either that, we can go in places, we can go in time. That's assuming it works. Or, we can go to Master Renio, whatever his name is. He's up here, and have him take us to, the Realm of Fallen Heroes, or whatever it's called. So, we're gonna mess around with space and time next episode, before we do that. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. Oh. Hold on.
Well met yourself.
I wanted to level him up. And I said I was going to. Increase edge. Wait. If we can increase his intellect, I don't think we can. Nope. Might. Done. Okay. Now, endure. In enduring, grow strong.